here since they decided to sit down on God and forgot why they were there and forgot what God called them to do. The Bible says in verse 6, something begins to happen in the area of their personal dwelling. Can I get a witness? In verse 6 it says, have you noticed that you've sown a lot, but you bring it home very little? Does it feel like you break your back at work seven days a week, and it seems like the pay is getting smaller or it's spread more thin than it used to be? It seems like you're working harder for less. Can I get a witness in here? Come on, somebody, come on. Y'all been in this bush economy. Wage is not going up, hallelujah, but the work and the demand on you is. He says you need to take notice that something's wrong. He said, have you noticed that you eat, but you still don't have enough? Have you noticed that you drink, but you're still thirsty, you're still not filled with drink? Say, neighbor, something's wrong. Have you noticed that you have on clothes, but you still seem to be cold? He says, have you noticed that it seems like you're earning wages or you're making money, but you're putting it into your bag or your pockets that have holes in them? Can I, come on, somebody. You get your paycheck on Friday, and by Monday you scratching your head wondering where it all went. Things popping up to take resources out of your pocket, and you don't understand where your money is going. He says something wrong. Consider your ways. He says it again in verse 7. Thus saith the Lord of hosts, consider your ways. He says, go up to the mountain. He said, this is what you need to do. What you did in the beginning. Go up to the mountain and bring wood and build the house. Then I will take pleasure in it and I will be glorified, saith the Lord. See, we get to a point where God blesses us more than we can stand, and then we forget the God who is the blesser. And we begin to serve the stuff more than the God who gave us the stuff. We forget about him. And we go home to our comfortable dwellings. And we leave the work to be done by somebody else. He says, consider your ways. Go up to the mountain, bring wood, and build this house. Verse 9, he says, you looked for much, and it came to you. You had great expectations. You were expecting that business deal to go through, and it didn't come to nothing. Something's wrong. And when you brought it home, watch this. God said, when you did bring it home, or you thought that you got all you needed, he said, I blew on it. See, he blew on your stuff. And you lost it all. My God. Why? God asked why? Why, saith the Lord of hosts? Because my house that is in waste, you run every man to his own house, and my house lays in shambles. I'm not talking about a physical house, but the church of the living God that is supposed to fulfill a mandate for reaching souls for Christ. Hallelujah. God sent people across your path who needed to hear the gospel, people who needed to hear your testimony, people who needed your witness so they can know that eventually God's going to make everything all right, but you close your mouth because you weren't concerned about their stuff. It has nothing to do with your house. People you could have been a blessing to, we turn a blind eye and we don't fulfill the mandate that God gave us. Then he blows on your stuff. You see, beloved, your blessing that had been coming so freely is literally connected to what you do for the kingdom. Can I get a witness in here? You see, you no longer live by the world's rules. See, you're in the world, but you're not of this world. Somebody's going to catch that. You live in this system, but